Event monitoring can enable live video panels to react to various types of events, such as motion detection from one or multiple sources. Event monitoring helps to make users aware of key events in busy environments and ensures that important video is brought to user attention. In order to designate a video window for event monitoring, you must first create an event monitoring profile. In this example, we will program the system to change our video displayed when motion is detected. To create a new profile, click the New button beneath the Profiles list. Give the profile a name, and if desired, a description. Using the Show Event List dropdown allows you to choose how you wish to display the event list window in live mode. Show Newest Event will ensure that the most recent event is displayed, assuming that it doesn't have a lower priority than a simultaneously occurring event. Next, you will need to specify video panel or view. Selecting video panel will change a single camera panel on an event. Selecting view will display a pre-configured view on an event. You will need to include at least one event in your profile, but multiple events may be configured. To create the event to be monitored, click the New button under the Client Actions list. Now, select an event type to monitor, as well as the event source. By default, event sources from all systems are shown. You may use the drop-down menu to filter to a specific system. In this example, we want to monitor for video motion and select a specific camera from the event source that we want to detect motion on. Once an event type and source have been selected, choose one of the action types you wish to perform when the event is triggered. Log will save a notification event in the client side and the monitor list. Play sound will allow you to choose a sound to be played when the event type is triggered. This can be used to gain attention to the monitor in a busy setting. The switch video action target allows you to automatically switch to a specific camera or camera view, and switch audio performs the same for audio sources. Additional options will either be digital preset or switch view tour, depending on whether video panel or view was selected above for the profile configuration. Digital preset will list pre-configured PTZ presets, while Switch View Tour will change to a saved tour. Some action types, such as views or tours, rely on prior configuration of views or tours on your system. Refer to other videos on their configurations. Repeat this process for any additional events you'd like to include. Click Apply when you are ready to save your changes. If you selected Show Event List, additional options will be displayed at the bottom of the page for each individual event. Events occurring simultaneously, such as motion from multiple cameras, can be prioritized by changing the priority value of each event. This ensures that your most important cameras or events are shown. Events with a priority of 1 will have the highest priority. The timeout determines how many seconds the event is displayed in the event monitor list. Selecting the Confirm checkbox will require the event to be acknowledged by the viewer. Finally, you may choose to display a message when the event occurs, such as an action a security guard might want to take when the event happens. Once created, you may activate the event monitor from the live page. Event monitor profiles are activated in two places depending on their type. Opening Live Views from the left displays the view type profiles at the bottom of the views list. Right-clicking a video panel in the Live Camera grid and expanding Event Monitor from the pop-up menu allows you to select from available video panel profiles. That panel will now be dedicated for the Event Monitor profile. The Event Monitor list displayed allows you to search for events in the window. Active events will be shown in the list and can be acknowledged by clicking the X next to the event or be reviewed by clicking the circular arrow.